I knew I wanted to be a doctor since I was 4, and I was very focused on that goal. From an Indigenous family. We're a Korean Anishinaabe. So we have been in Manitoba since time immemorial. But growing up in the north end of Winnipeg, I didn't really experience racism as directly as I did once I got into medical school. I felt very isolated as an Indigenous woman, as a racialized woman, in trying to navigate these gender and race power dynamics within medicine, while at the same time just trying to be a doctor. Most of the work that I do is in Indigenous health. When I'm working with Indigenous people, it feels like I'm working with my family. And on one hand, that's great. I think it makes me a better physician to feel like that. But particularly when I see the racism that Indigenous people experience in healthcare, it hurts. And so that creates a level of urgency and passion and fire for the work that I do. But it also is a level of emotional work that a lot of my non-Indigenous colleagues don't have to process in the same way. I mentor a fair number of medical students, and one of the things I tell them is to pace themselves. Figure out who you are and what your piece of the work is to do, because there's no lack of work. Particularly for young Indigenous physicians, because our people are experiencing such significant health gaps, because so many of our kids are in care. The drive to contribute is so strong, but we need to be able to do that in ways that are aligned with our purpose and preserve our work for the long term.